Alkane Resources Managing Director Nic Earner is with me now to talk through the company's latest quarter. Nic, good to see you again.
Good to see you too, Jonathan. Thank you.
So the quarter was below forecast, but there were reasons for that. Can you explain the numbers for us?
Well, the primary reason that we were below what we forecast for the quarter was that we mined through an area in Caloma Two, part of our existing underground at Tomingley, that had much higher carbonaceous material in it than we'd forecast. This area we've mined has typically had a sort of a 65 to 70% recovery, but it's had a higher head grade, typically sort of 2.5 odd grams a ton. It had that head grade, but it had a higher carbon content than we anticipated. And as a result, recovery in that area was down around sort of 30, 40% just for this particular block's ore, which, you know, knocked a few thousand ounces off the forecast that we expected. And so, you know, logically, you know, what are we doing about that going forward? Well, number one, we've mined through that area already, but number two, we've gone back all through that Caloma area and resampled for carbon and the type of carbon that it is that causes it to be preg-robbing. So yeah, not expected, a little disappointing, but behind us now.
And important to note there, though, that the full year guidance, it hasn't changed.
Yeah, that's correct. It's because we've moved into Roswell as our primary source. And Roswell, you know, as people have heard me say many times before, is higher grade. So logically, you know, we're very dependent on the performance, the ramp up and the performance of those stopes to meet our full year guidance. We think we can. And, you know, we'll be at the lower end of production guidance and the higher end of costs. But yeah, Roswell performing as we anticipate, and the production and mining in there performing as anticipated. Yeah, we'll meet that guidance for this quarter. It should be coming home with a wet sail very strongly.
And Nic, you are in a cash spend situation at the moment, and it's going to the projects. Can you give us an update on where the cash is going and how the projects are coming along?
Yeah, well, people will have noted that, you know, with our cash of and investments of approximately a bit over $40 million, then another $50 million debt facility, which we've upsized to 60, and I'll talk about that a little later. That, you know, our total liquidity is $90 million. We're about halfway through a bit more spending on particularly the paste plant and the processing fine grind and flotation upgrades. So we'll see more cash being spent in the current quarter or in the June quarter and then the September quarter. But then the cash spending is largely behind, apart from bits that flow into the December quarter from those, because both of them are scheduled to be commissioning in, you know, late September. So we should be seeing ourselves move into a genuine cash generation position in either December quarter or next March quarter. So things are going well. We're on track for both of those projects, and that's just the nature of the capital expansion that we're doing. But, you know, people need to remember, of course, we're locking in our mine life, you know, past 2030 at pretty good production rates as well.
And you've thrown some put options into the mix as well. Can you talk us through that?
Yeah, well, when we took out the debt for this extension project, which was nearly you know, a year ago today, put that $50 million in place, then, you know, the gold price was at $2,700-$2,800, and the cost of taking options back then would have been really high, so we took flat forwards. But that those flat forwards have an average price of, you know, just a bit above $2,800 an ounce. And so with the current spot price now, and sorry, and that was for sort of 40% of production over the debt period. And so if you look at the spot price now being, I'll say $3,700 an ounce, but it's pretty volatile, as you know, listeners would know. If we look at that, then taking put options at $3,000 an ounce is quite, you know, acceptable. You end up with an average price over that period we put them out through to 27 of about, you know, $60 Australian an ounce. And so, you know, what we have that means is across this debt period and then through this investment period, but particularly this period as we're getting to Roswell, the rest of our production, the other 60%, won't be sold, or a vast majority of the rest of our production won't be sold for less than $3,000 Aussie an ounce. So that, there's a lot of benefits that come out of that, not just the financial shorting, but particularly as we go to plan our underground and what stopes we do and don't take and when we take them in the sequence, it's really good knowing, okay, this is the price minimum that it's going to move for. And it also, of course, it keeps the upside open, which wasn't a position we had a year ago when we took out the hedges. So yeah, it's just a you know, prudent cash management and planning decision that we've taken there.
So everything's moving forward. What can we see next?
Well, next week we should be putting out the Kaiser resource for Boda and Kaiser, and then we'll be working on the mine plans for that, which will let us, that's the last missing piece out of the scoping study. So late May, early June, we should be putting out that scoping study for Boda. And then of course, right now we're updating the Tomingley plans. So now we put those put options in place, we'll be looking at, okay, what's exactly our mine plan over the next 3 to 5 years with that degree of certainty there. We're currently out to tender at the moment for the moving of the highway to enable us to make the decision around the open cut and the timing of that. And yeah, and then of course we've got the gold price where it's at. So in June, we'll be putting out our, you know, 3 to 5 year look ahead for Tomingley to give people a lot more clarity on what our thoughts are about that going forward once the budgets are settled.
Nick, look forward to speaking to you again, and thanks for your time.
Lots to talk about. Thank you.